There is no God 100% proof by Andrew Johnson. How do you get something from nothing? You see, time is faced with a paradox. It needs to be different things at the same time. 13 trillion needs to be 0, and 0 needs to be 13 trillion. 13 trillion needs to also keep on getting older. Basically, it needs to be all times at once, ubiquity, omnipresence, and solved it.
There is no God 100% proof by Andrew Johnson.
How do we get something from nothing? See, time and space is a paradox. We need to be different things at the same time. 50 trillion years needs to be 0, and 0 needs to be 50 trillion. 50 trillion years will also keep on getting older. Basically, it needs to be all kinds of ones of equity, one presence, and all. There's only one thing present when there's nothing. We need to set the last of the one that comes before us acts on a massive body and causes it to accelerate. There's nothing for 50 trillion years that comes before us if the time is time itself. Time will be also 3 years old, but also a minute and a million years old. Each of you could also be making time accelerate relative to the speed time. First time acts on a massive body accumulation of time causes it to accelerate. It's faster than speed of light as it passes in. The time has its limits. If we reduce time to the smallest interval, the mind trip, or the smallest unit of time that time can measure, also a small distance or the absolute zero of time, if time is truly an absolute zero, it would not exist. It would not exist. Time has gaps where no time exists. It's not 100% accurate. Two small gaps and distance between a mind trip or another, where there is no time to use space. So when time is accelerated, it falls into the space of dimension. Dimension and space are both created by time. Time is the smallest and the youngest thing, a mind trip is the second biggest thing, the second oldest thing, the super universe, and I'm saying the biggest and oldest thing, the super clock, the Raymond. So since you're chilling time, he's a badass. He has a force of acceleration, he needs to be in time. So 50 trillion time, he's the badass. He has a force of acceleration. When he needs to be time mind tripper, he turns around and falls back to himself and enters into a dimension and starts to clock back and create a super universe and ends. She's a rebirth of ancient time, if you will. When mind tripper needs to be a time, he enters any of the dimensions that time needs to be. A mind tripper is 68% dark energy spread evenly in the universe via time slots. When that's 100% mind tripper in the form of a wall boundary, she's a true outsider. She can never change, interact with anything else. She's the oldest time at this level and needs to stay longer. 27% dark matter in the universe spread randomly. The mind trippers. With dark energy running into each other, forming mind tripper clusters, dark matter at the beginning of we share time slots. It is random and even, I've ignored the oldest part of the universe. More time and less time in this part is less time. The super clock, the ring, is the closest thing to achieve absolute perfect symmetry. At the center of the ring, you can put time mind tripper. You're like the hands of a clock, with using dimensions to move. From there, you draw long strands of time, each line is a dimension, space, and gaps where no time exists. The first ring of this time only creates the first dimension, space, and it's the only level that contains the oldest time. But at the same time, the dimension started to reveal another dimension, spread all around at the distance of a mind tripper. The Nancy level, they are parallel Nancy's or parallel super universes. Nancy's law bond is the second oldest time after the first Raymond. So in our universe, we have a super clock Raymond. In our universe, we also have a super clock Raymond at this level. It's parallel with the universe that's verified in this collision of the universe. So we have to realize the theory of everything is all parallel amongst us. It's really all parallel universe that's being created at the same time all around at the time distance of a mind tripper. All parallel universes share time and so come into existence within time. As we grow, we are perceived with mind tripper's dark energy, then mind tripper clusters dark matter. The normal energy, when they get old, we feel them electromagnetic. It starts to share between parallel universes. The Big Bang will have to be revised. It's a big time crunch, right? After the universe is created, it has a different time to punch it. It will start entering. Starts off the size of a mind chipper. In this case, the density of massive mind body, I like it because it's the same punch as ancient time. How old? How old are you say your age is out loud. How old are you? Say your age is out loud. Yeah, how old are you? Say your age is out loud. You were wrong, you were about 4 years old. Teenage physics for being dates back to the first single cell organism that appeared on Earth. It's a non-broken chain of life that's only part of last time for 4 billion years. Time has created time ecosystems. We are a physical manifestation of time. We are batteries that store time, as it's all normal energy. Your plan as a star, batteries that store time. We are batteries that store time. It is time's advantage to create systems that are long lived. How old are you? Say your age is not loud. How old are you? Say your age is not loud. You're wrong, you're about 4 billion years old. Your true age of physical being gets back to the first. Time that's created time ecosystems. We are physical manifestation of time. We are batteries that store time. That's created time ecosystems. We are the physical manifestation of time.
Yes.